His army will be strong and mighty in the Lord. His upcoming end time army will be militant in the spirit. They are everyone that has the same burning passion, desire, his kingdom and bringing in the great harvest. They are not just you. Master's prophetic army with Pastor Adebanjo.
Welcome to another episode of this special program that the Lord is using to raise up an end-time army for himself. The Lord is using to prepare us for something great. The Lord is using it to separate us from the darkness and the corruption that is in this world and to prepare us for something greater in his kingdom, to bring down and to establish his kingdom upon the face of the earth. And I know that the Lord has been blessing you through this program. I've received some of your testimonies, and I know that God is able to do even greater and more abundantly than what he's been doing for you so far. So I want you to believe God, I want you to listen, and I want you to pray and seek the face of God even more concerning your destiny. It's not enough to just listen and to hear these things and to talk about them, but pray about them. Seek the face of God, and he will reveal his plan to you. Remember that scripture: no eye has seen, no ear has heard, and no mind has conceived what he has prepared for us. But by his spirit, he's revealing, he's unfolding his plans to those that love him. So he will unfold his plans to you by his spirit. So please make sure you don't just listen, but pray and seek the face of the Lord, and he will show you his plan and he will show you his will. For the past few weeks, we've been looking at the number 28, and some years ago, the Lord began to speak to me about that number in scripture, and he used that number to reveal to me his end time plans for his kingdom upon the face of the earth. And we looked at Genesis chapter 1 verse 28. The original commission that was given to humanity is: be fruitful, multiply, replenish the earth, subdue it. Meaning that the Lord was calling humanity to fill the earth with his glory, to subdue the earth with his glory, to fill the earth with the glory of God as the waters cover the sea. It is God's will and God's plan that he should tabernacle amongst men. It is God's will that he will reveal himself to us, humanity. He will give himself to us, humanity, in a love relationship, which he likened to a husband and a wife, or Christ and his bride. That is God's original intention and his plan. But for that to happen, the earth needs to be prepared. And that is the commission he gave to Adam: prepare the earth to carry the glory of God. So when we see that the Lord is asking him to till the ground and to prepare the garden, it's bigger than just preparing a garden. It is preparing the earth to be filled with the glory of God. It is preparing the earth to be a carrier of the throne of God. So the earth has a purpose, the earth has a destiny, and humanity is part of that destiny, and humanity is meant to prepare the earth for that destiny. But unfortunately, as a result of the fall of man and corruption, the earth, instead of being full of the glory of God, has been filled with all kinds of wickedness. The Bible says, in the dark places of the earth are the habitations of cruelty, habitations of wickedness. And as a result, the earth is groaning, the earth is reacting, because it is out of sync with its divine destiny. But it is for this purpose that the Lord is raising you in these end times, so that the earth can be full of his glory once again. That even though darkness covers the earth and gross darkness covers the people, it is God's plan that he will arise upon you and his glory will be seen upon your life. This is your calling, this is your destiny, to bring back the tabernacle of God so that God can dwell amongst men once again. We also looked at Genesis 5:28. A son was born to Lamech, and that son is Noah. And that is a pointer to the fact that in the last days, or in the end times, it will be likened to the days of Noah, where there was wickedness, but God called Noah, and Noah found grace in the sight of the Lord. And the Lord is calling you the same way he called Noah. In the midst of wickedness, he's calling you. He's calling you to set yourself apart for him. And Jesus prophesied that the days of the coming of the Son of Man will just be like the days of Noah. We also looked at Genesis chapter 28. where he talked about Jacob being given a commission or a charge by his father not to get married to any of the Canaanite girls, but to go and seek for a godly wife. And in the same way, the Lord is charging us, his church, not to join ourselves with the world, but to come out from the world and be separate and be joined unto him if we are going to establish his kingdom here on earth. In that same scripture, we see in Genesis 28, we see that that Jacob slept and he had a dream and a divine encounter where God met with him in his dream. And he saw a ladder descend from heaven to earth, which is a revelation of God's plan for the earth, that heaven and earth be connected once again. When Adam fell, there was a disconnection, there was a separation between heaven and earth, and the earth was given to darkness. But it is God's will that once again there will be an establishment of a connection between heaven and earth, where angels will come freely and angels will descend and ascend, where the Lord will speak to man once again, where the Lord will dwell and tabernacle with man again. And it is because of that vision that Jacob was given that he named that place the house of God. He said, "This is the gate of heaven and I knew it not. This is the house of God." And he named it Bethel. Bethel means the house of God. That tells us that it is God's will that he should dwell with man again. God wants his house on the earth. God wants his glory on the earth. And this is why the angels keep asking, "What is man that you are mindful of him? Why would you choose a rebellious people to want to dwell and to tabernacle with them?" The angels do not understand this mystery. And they keep asking, "What is man that you are mindful of him?" Isn't that a great mystery about the love of God? The Bible says, "Behold, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us that we should be called the sons of God." Because we do not deserve to be called the sons of God. But look at the manner of love, the great love that he has bestowed upon us. That even though we were fallen and were rebellious, he has chosen us to become his sons. He has still chosen us to be carriers of his glory. He still says, "I want to dwell amongst men." He's still saying that, "I want to dwell with humanity. I want to tabernacle with humanity." And this will come to pass. You remember the book of Revelation where that angel speaks with a loud voice, "Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men." That is the end. The tabernacle of God is going to, who is going to establish his righteous kingdom and his government, rose from the dead. Matthew 28. That tells us of God's plan for his son, who overcame sin, who overcame Satan, and who overcame death, to rule and to reign forever. In that same Matthew chapter 28, the resurrected Lord and Savior Jesus Christ spoke to his disciples. That same Matthew 28, he said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given unto me." That's a very deep statement. The authority on earth was lost by Adam. The authority that God gave Adam in Genesis 1:28 that he lost was restored in Matthew chapter 28. So what Adam lost, that authority to be fruitful, the authority to multiply, the authority to subdue the earth, the authority to be in charge and in control of the earth and to establish the glory of God in the earth, Adam lost it to the devil, and the devil became the prince of this world. But in Matthew chapter 28, that authority was restored back to the Lord Jesus. He paid the price for it. He fought for it, and he took it back rightfully. He rightfully took it back, having met the righteous requirements of God, having succeeded where Adam failed, having overcome the same temptation that Adam went through. Because the Lord Jesus was tempted in all points, in the area of the lust of the flesh, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life, and he overcame. So he rightfully took back the authority that Adam lost. And in Matthew chapter 28, he told his disciples, "Now all authority in heaven and on earth has been given unto me." Isn't that wonderful? And the next verse, he now said, "Go therefore," meaning as a result of the authority that I now have, "go in my name and make disciples of all nations. Go and preach the gospel to every creature. Go and redeem the earth from the darkness of the fallen cosmos. Go and redeem the earth from sin and from wickedness." That is what the Lord Jesus spoke to his disciples. And he now added a statement. He said, "Lo, I am with you even unto the end of the age." So the last phrase in Matthew chapter 28 is "to the end of the age." That tells you that this number 28 is telling us about the end of the age and the establishment of God's kingdom upon the face of the earth. Another 28th scripture we need to look at is the book of Daniel chapter 2 verse 28. Now in Daniel chapter 2, Nebuchadnezzar, the king of Babylon, he had a dream. And that dream had to do with the end of the world and the establishment of the kingdom of God. And this king, even though he did not remember the dream at when he woke up, he was troubled and his spirit was totally restless. He knew that he had a very important and a very significant dream, but he could not recall. He could not recall it. Maybe partly because of he's not being a child of God, you know. So his spirit is not able to retain information from heaven. So he forgot about the dream. His spirit man was not fully developed to handle the information from heaven. And he needed a child of light, a child of the kingdom of God, somebody who had the Holy Spirit to recall that dream and to interpret it. He first started with his astrologers and his magicians and his stargazers. He summoned all of them and gave them a charge that they should remember his dream and they should tell him the meaning. If not, he was going to kill all of them. And Daniel heard about this. And Daniel came to the king and told the king, "Give me some time, let me pray and seek the face of the Lord, and he will reveal it unto me." Now Daniel chapter 2 verse 28 is the verse where Daniel speaks to the king and says, "There is a God in heaven who reveals secrets, and he has shown the king what will happen in the latter days." Have you opened your Bible to it? Daniel chapter 2 verse 28, you read it there. That is the verse where it says, "There is a God in heaven who reveals secrets. There is a God in heaven who reveals mysteries, and he has shown you what will happen in the last days." So you can see Genesis 28 has to do with the house of God being established on the earth. Matthew 28 ended with "till the end of the age." And Daniel 2:28 is talking about what will happen in the last days. So that is what God showed Nebuchadnezzar. And Daniel told Nebuchadnezzar the dream. He said, "You were looking and you saw a huge image, a mighty image. The head was gold. The chest and the arms were made of silver. The belly and the thighs were made of brass. The legs were made of iron, and the feet were made of iron and clay." And if you read the whole of Daniel chapter 2, you will see the interpretation of that dream is that those different parts of the image represented the kingdoms of this world. And in that dream, a stone was released from heaven that crushed the image completely and ground it to dust, and the wind blew it away, and that kingdom was no more. And Daniel interpreted the dream and said that in the last days shall the Lord set up a kingdom that will never be removed forever and ever. And that kingdom is going to destroy the kingdoms, the previous kingdoms that were before it, which represents the kingdom of men that were backed up by evil spirits or backed up by an unseen force, which we can see later in the book of Revelation. But the important thing is this. In Daniel 2:28, the Lord revealed, the God in heaven who reveals secrets and mysteries, he revealed his plan to Nebuchadnezzar, to Daniel, and through the scripture, he revealed his plan to all of us about the end times, that he's going to set up a kingdom that will never be removed. But for that kingdom to be set up, there's going to be a collision between the stone from heaven and the image of darkness, which is the kingdom of God and the kingdom of darkness are going to have a head-on collision in these last days. But we know the result. The Bible says that the kingdoms of this world will become the kingdoms of our Lord and of his Christ, and he will reign forever and ever. So Daniel chapter 2 verse 28 talks about that mystery, what will happen in the last days. Another 28th scripture we need to look at is the book of Luke chapter 2 verse 28. In this scripture, the baby Jesus was brought to a prophet And the prophet picked up that baby and began to prophesy. I want us to read that verse together in Luke chapter 2, verse 28. He took him up in his arms and blessed God, saying, Lord, now that you are letting your servant depart in peace, according to your word, for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared before the face of all people, a light to bring revelation to the Gentiles and the glory of your people Israel. And Joseph and his mother marveled at those things which were spoken of him. Verse 34, and Simeon blessed them and said to Mary his mother, behold, this child is destined for the fall and the rising of many in Israel, and for a sign which will be spoken against. Yes, a sword will pierce through your own soul also, that the thoughts of many hearts may be revealed. So you can see in that scripture, in verse 28, Simeon picked up the Lord Jesus and his spiritual eyes were opened, and he began to prophesy about the destiny of the Lord Jesus, that he will be set for the rising and the falling of many, talking about the falling of the kingdom of darkness, the rising of the kingdom of God, the establishment of the kingdom of God in these end times. Isn't it amazing that that was revealed in Luke chapter 2, verse 28? The Spirit of God came upon him and he prophesied this. And Mary and Joseph, they were shocked. They were shocked at the words that were spoken about their baby that they were carrying. But this was revealed to us, the end time plan of God, that even though he was a baby at that time, he was set for a kingdom. He was set for the establishment of his government and his authority in the earth. And that many will fall, the kingdoms of this world will fall, and the kingdom of God will arise and will be established. This is God's end time plan. Another 28th scripture we need to consider is the book of Joel chapter 2 verse 28, where it says, in the last days I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh. Your sons and your daughters will prophesy, your young men will see visions, and your old men will dream dreams. This is God's plan for his end times, for the end times on the earth, that one more time he's going to pour out his spirit in a measure that has never been seen before, so that he will open your eyes to see the glories of his kingdom. He will open your eyes to speak to you about the things that will happen on the earth. He will show you wonders in heaven. He will show you mysteries, because there are so many mysteries that have been sealed and that can only be revealed in these days. You remember when the Lord spoke to Daniel, he told Daniel, seal up these things. It's not for your generation. It is for the time of the end. Some things that were given to John as well, he asked John to seal them up and not to write them down, because they were not for his generation. It is for our generation. And many of those mysteries, many of those secrets will be revealed. Remember, Daniel 2:28, there is a God in heaven that reveals mysteries. There is a God in heaven that reveals secrets. And in these last days, he is pouring out his spirit, Joel 2:28, so that when we become prophets, we can have access to the mysteries of God, so that he can speak and he can reveal his end time mysteries and his plans to us. This is the purpose of the anointing promised in Joel chapter 2 verse 28. It is a purpose that has the end in sight, that has the end as a goal. The reason why the Lord is pouring out his prophetic anointing upon us in these last days is not for us to be prophesying and making money, or it's not for us to be prophesying mundane things. The prophecies of the end times have to do with the establishment of God's kingdom and God's righteousness. And it is for this purpose that he is pouring out his spirit upon all flesh. Are you ready to stand with the Lord and with his kingdom? If you are ready to fight for the kingdom, then the promise of Joel chapter 2 verse 28 is for you. The God in heaven who reveals mysteries, he will pour out his spirit upon you. He will open your spiritual eyes and your spiritual ears so that you can see his plan, and so that you can hear his voice, so that you can prophesy his will to this generation. The same way Noah, His eyes and ears were opened, and he was shown the judgments that were coming. And he prophesied it, and he spoke about it to his generation, warning them of things to come. The book of Hebrews chapter 11 says, Noah by faith, being warned of God, he prophesied and he warned the people of things to come. And by faith, he built an ark. He built an ark for the saving of his household. So the Spirit of God came upon him. His spiritual eyes were open. His spiritual ears were open. And he knew what was coming on the earth. In the same way, the Bible says that our days, or the days of the coming of the Son of Man, shall be like the days of Noah. There will be darkness on the earth, but the Lord will open the eyes of those who have found favor in his sight, and you are one of them. And today, we are going to pray for an outpouring of his Spirit upon you, so that the eyes of your understanding can be enlightened. This is the prayer that Paul prayed for the Ephesian church. He said, I pray that the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ will give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him, so that the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, you will know what is the hope of his calling, and you will know the exceeding greatness of his power, the power that he wrought when he raised Jesus up from the dead. And of course, you know that he was raised up from the dead in Matthew chapter 28. The Lord is calling you for that purpose. The Lord is calling you. He wants to open your eyes. He wants to pour out his anointing upon you. Joel 2:28 is a last day's anointing. And it's going to happen in our days. And I want you to get yourself ready, because as we pray today, the Lord is speaking right now that he's going to pour out that anointing upon you. He's going to open your spiritual eyes right now, and you will see his glory. You will see his power. You will see his kingdom. You will see his great call upon your life. Rise to your feet now and let us pray. Lord, I thank you for your promise in Joel chapter 2 verse 28 that it shall come to pass afterwards that you will pour out your spirit upon all flesh. Lord, I pray for your sons and daughters watching this program right now. Let there be a release of your spirit upon them right now in the name of the Lord Jesus. Lord, I ask that they be filled with the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of you, Lord. Let the eyes of their understanding be opened in the name of Jesus. Let the eyes of their understanding be opened right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, I ask that you release your fire upon them right now. Lord, you said in your word that you make your ministers a flame of fire. Lord, I ask right now that you make all your sons and daughters watching this program, make them a flame of fire right now in the name of Jesus. Lord, reveal yourself to them. Open their mouth to prophesy your will, your counsel, and your plan to this generation, Lord. In the name of the Lord Jesus, O God in heaven, the one who reveals mysteries, I ask that beginning from now, you will begin to reveal your mysteries to every single one of your dear sons and daughters, Lord. Just as it is written in Daniel 2:28, that there is a God in heaven who reveals mysteries. Lord, reveal mysteries to them right now by your Spirit. In the name of the Lord Jesus, you said in your word that by your Spirit you have revealed your plans to them that love you. Lord, I ask that beginning from tonight, you will reveal your plans to your dear sons and daughters, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Oh, thank you, Father, for the answer. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I can feel the power of God. I can feel the presence of God. And I know that you can feel that same power and that same presence. The Lord has planted something great in your life. Please write to me telling me what the Lord has done for you today. And please don't stop praying. Seek the face of God even more, and he will reveal his plan to you. I look forward to seeing you again. Same time next week. God bless you.